Yeah, yeah. Nah, 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 nah. Yeah. It's Batty, baby, oh. Batty, baby, oh. Nah, 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 yeah. It's your happy day. It's your wedding day. Make we celebrate, oh. Make we celebrate, oh. To make you dance, dance.
Hey, loves, welcome back to my channel. How are you guys all doing? I hope you guys are having a fantastic weekend, by the way. So today's video is actually going to be a protective style. So I'll basically be putting my short 4C natural hair in a slick down jumbo pigtail braids. It's actually been a while since I actually slicked down my natural hair. I was like, okay, today, why not? So the first thing I went ahead to do, like you guys already saw, was to wet my natural hair, just so my hair is a lot easier to work with. And then after doing that, I went ahead to use my Kentsu leave-in conditioner to moisturize and also soften my natural hair. And then afterwards, I went ahead to use my Jamaican black castor oil to make sure my hair is properly moisturized, juicy, and ready for this slick down process. So the product I'll be using today to slick down my hair is the Style Factor Edge Booster gel, not the pomade, the gel. So I'm going to go ahead to use this to slick down my hair into these two pigtail braids, and I'm going to go ahead to make sure that I'm slicking down my hair in sections as per usual. So if your hair gets dry, like you guys can see, mine gets dry in between the process, so I normally go ahead to wet my hair again just so my hair is a lot easier to manipulate. And then I'll use my afro comb to detangle my hair, just comb it out, make sure your hair is detangled. In that way, it's a lot easier to hold it together and make sure it's properly sleek. So now I'll go ahead to use this gel to start applying this, and then go over that with my Bristol brush and make sure I brush this really nice and smooth. And then go ahead using my elastic band and just hold that together. And as I'm doing this, I'm just making sure that I'm separating my hair using my butterfly clamps. And I just go through this exact same process in sections like I already mentioned. So like I said, if your hair gets dry again along the way, just make sure you spray some water and then just detangle it using your afro comb, or basically like any big comb you have around. Just make sure your natural hair is detangled, just to avoid any lumpy bumpy right on your head, you know, so everything can slick down properly. And then after doing the whole detangling process and making sure your hair is soft enough to manipulate and moisturize, then you can proceed to using your gel to slick it down, and then your Bristol brush to make sure that the hair is actually properly held together, and then use your elastic band to hold this. So normally I get asked this question, how long does this hairstyle last? For me, when I slick down my hair, I actually carry it for 5 to 7 days. Oftentimes I carry for 1 week. Ever since I started using this Style Factor gel, I noticed that my hair actually stays longer before it starts to flake. So normally I end up carrying the hairstyle for about 7 to 8 days. But when I use the Eco Styler gel, I end up carrying the hairstyle for about 5 days before the flaking gets kind of like obvious. And then I take it and I wash it off. So I feel like the Style Factor gel actually has a better hold, a longer lasting hold that actually retains for a very long time compared to the Eco Styler gel. And then another thing to take note of is that once your hair is moisturized, it's less prone to flaking. So it's always important to make sure that you moisturize your hair before you slick it down. Like you guys see, I normally go ahead to use my conditioner, and then I use my oil again just to make sure my hair is actually properly moisturized before I do any slick down process. Because the reality of it is that when your hair slicks down, it stays literally matte, so it's prone to flaking if there was no moisture on your hair prior to it being matte. So it's always good to make sure your hair is moisturized and everything is juicy and ready to be slicked down. Then another thing to actually also take note of is working your hair in sections. Like, this is so important. Working your hair in sections. If your hair is a lot thicker than mine, you will have to work your hair in very, very small sections. If your hair is even shorter than mine, or really, really short, you will have to work your hair in very small sections as well. If your hair is very thin and long, you can get away with working in big sections. But if your hair is thick, you will have to work in small sections. I know it seems like it's a lot of work, But if you put in the work, oh my God, you will love the results. Just do it step by step. Be patient, take your time. So now that I'm basically done slicking down my hair into these two ponytails, like you guys can see, and making sure that everything is, you know, I'll just go ahead to lay my edges. I try not to make my edges not to be too extra. I feel like I like the edges look, but like, you know, I like it to be subtle, not too much kind of thing. So I'll just go ahead to lay my edges. And then after laying my edges, I will use my satin head wrap as per usual to lay down my hair, slick it down, tie it up. And then I actually slept off with this hair like this overnight. So this is basically the following morning. You guys can see how my hair looks very... Oh my God. So now I'll just go ahead to braid my natural hair ponytail into like just like a very smooth braid, just so I can be able to swell that and put my natural hair in a bun, just so I'll be able to attach the extension that I'll be using in the future very neatly and nice. And then I'll just use my elastic band to hold this my natural hair in a bun. Normally, before putting this elastic band on my head, I always like to make sure that I put some oil just to moisturize it and prevent it from breaking my natural hair, just so it just stays that way and it's very easy to come off when it's time to come off. So after holding my natural hair in a bun, I'll just go ahead to use this pre-stretched braiding hair that I got from my local beauty supply store. And I think this is color 1 and it's 26 inches. Like I said, it's already stretched out for you, so you don't even have to stretch it out. I got this hair for $1.99, so $1.99. So I'll just grab the hair right off the pack. It already came with an elastic band. I'll attach this to my natural hair bun, like you guys can see. Just properly attach that, make sure it's secure and nice. So when it's attached, you want to make sure you go ahead to take just a little bit of hair out, just out of the way. This is what we're going to use to actually hold the hair down and to actually give the hair more of a blended look. You see what I mean when we get there. So now I'll just go ahead to use the rest of the hair that's left and just make my normal 3-strand braids all the way down to the end. So for this hairstyle, I use 2 packs of this hair extension. So I use 1 pack of extension per side of the ponytail and I use the other 1 pack on the other side of the ponytail. For this hairstyle, I also often get asked, how do I normally keep it intact? Like, how do I maintain it? So you guys will see towards the end of this video, I actually showed you guys normally what I do at night before I go to bed and also what I do before I go to the gym, just to make sure that my hair is just staying this exact same way. Of course, the edges are not going to stay the exact same way, but like the entire head staying sleek, like you guys will see towards the end of the video. Now that we've braided the hair all the way down to the very end, I'll just go ahead to grab this braided extension and curve it over my natural hair bun. In that way, I'll just use that to cover the bun really nice, like you guys can see. Just cover it, press it down, poof it in where it's supposed to be poofed, and then grab the rest of the extension that we left out, comb it out, make sure it's tangled, and then go ahead to use my Got To Be Frizz spray and then use this to hold down the extension, the braids that we just did. Hold it down to my natural hair bun just so it's secure and it looks flawlessly merged into my natural hair, if that makes sense. So I'll just do that, keep making sure that I'm holding it tight, and then using my Got To Be spray where necessary to give it a proper seal, a proper hold, so it just stays that way, like sucked in. You know what I mean? As you guys can see, I didn't have to use any bobby pin because my hair already came pre-stretched. So I just used the last few strands of the hair to make a quick seal, wrapped it around the ponytail, and it just locked in properly. However, if your extension is not pre-stretched and it has more of a blunt end, you would have to use a bobby pin to properly hold it down in place. But if you go ahead to stretch out the end, it's always easy to use that last thin few strands from the extension to just lock it in without having to use a bobby pin. So that's basically one thing I feel like, yes, I think everyone should know that. There is a girl so lovely to me. She is the reason I dare to believe. Love can be simple, pure and
with some time, and I take her heart with me wherever I go. She's one in a million, she helps me to grow. The life that she gives is something I need to survive. And I'd go to the sun and back for her love.
So now that I'm done doing both sides of this jumbo pigtail braid, I'll just go ahead to trim out all the excess hair on the body, just trim out all the flyaways, and then after trimming the hair, I'll just go ahead to dip the ends of this hair in hot water just so it soaks it properly and everything is sealed. It doesn't have to unravel, it's just locked and it just stays that way for as long as you want. After doing that, I went ahead to use my mousse. This mousse is also going to give an extra hold and also help to lay down like any extra flyaways that could be poking left, right, or center on this extension. Just rub this all the way down to the very end of these braids, from the beginning all the way down to the end. And then after using the mousse, I went ahead to use my olive oil sheen spray to give my hair some shine, you know, shine, shine, and just give it some glow as well. And I went ahead to use my satin head wrap again to hold it down, make sure everything is locked in nice. And then yes, this is the entire look, you guys. This is basically what this look looks like. It's so cute, right? I know. And I went ahead to accessorize my hair using some hair jewelry. To go to bed or during like my workout, I normally just grab this hair, the two strands on the side, and just tie it like make a knot. You don't have to pull it too tight, because if you pull it too tight, you might be pulling it out from your hair. So just tie it and just ravel it around. Then I normally go ahead to use my hair net to hold it down together. Oh my god, this is actually a style, you know, like this. Use my hair net, and then over the hair net, I just go ahead to use my satin head wrap and tie it. And that's basically it, you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you did, don't forget to give me a big thumbs up, comment, share, subscribe, and I will see you guys in my next video. I love you guys so much. Have a wonderful rest of your weekend. Bye.